Hello, Explorers. In the last mission, we set up GraphQL to work with our Nuxt application and rendered the result from Strapi onto our Nuxt.js application. In this mission, we'll start off in VS Code. Continuing where we left off in the last mission, we displayed the article title on our Nuxt.js page. Going forward, we want to change up the structure and design of this page. So we'll start off at the bottom in the style section and post in some styling. At the top of our page in our template section, we want to change the overall structure of our web page. We'll get rid of the content in this div tag so we can start to build out the structure of our homepage. We'll copy this div tag so it's easy for us to make additional divs. In the root div, we'll change the class from container to home. And below that, we'll create an h1 tag and give it a class of headline and center. Inside the h1 tag, we'll type lyric blog and close it. In the next div, we'll have a class of sections. And inside this, we'll have another div that will give a class of group. This will store all the entries that we'll read from Strapi. And now we need to create a div where we can iterate over the data we get from Strapi. Inside this div, we'll use the v4 directive. And have article in articles, have a vbind, and we'll give this a key of article.id and a class of section. We'll have another div, and in this div, we'll have a class of entry. In this div, we'll have Nuxt link, which is a Nuxt component that helps us navigate in internal pages. We'll have an address internally that we can navigate to. We'll open the curly brackets and give this a path of article.slug. And we'll have a query item that we want to send over in our Nuxt link object of ID. And we'll give this ID the value of article.id. Wrap this in parentheses, and because we want the blog post title to be clickable, we'll place an h3 tag and interpolate article.title. We'll have a span tag, which will give a class of subtitle to hold our date. article.date. And we'll close that. We can close our h3 tag and our Nuxt link tag. We also want to have a p tag. This p tag is what we use to display our article description. So we'll interpolate article.description and close our p tag. We've built out the structure of our page. We can now save and go into our browser to see what this looks like. Awesome. We have lyric blog, our blog title, appearing, Gemini, our song title and description, as well as the date. I took the liberty of adding other entries in the Strapi admin. So you can add your favorite songs too and have them display and have them displayed here. In the blog that I demoed at the beginning of our mission, we were able to click on blog entries and look at the blog body. At the moment, when we click an entry, we get an error message. That's very okay. We haven't built out a page to display that data yet. To do that, we're going to leverage Nuxt.js dynamic pages functionality. Dynamic pages are very useful when you're fetching data from an API and you aren't sure of what data you might have. That way we can have some sort of template and render data. No matter what data we get, we know the structure of the data we're getting from Strapi, so we can build out a template to render that type of data and build a page dynamically, as the name suggests. So we'll go back into VS Code, and in our pages folder, we'll create a new file called _slug.view. Giving an underscore to a file name in the pages directory makes this page dynamic. So we'll start out with building out the structure of our page. It's very similar to the structure of our index page. So I'll go over to our index page copy everything, and paste it. Now we have the styling, the script section, and the template. We'll start out with our script section. In this page, our query will be very different. But before we can do that, we need to go back into our queries.js folder. In this folder, we had a single article query, which we used to get a single article from Strapi specified by our ID. However, because we're unsure of what articles we might want and the value of the ID will change, we'll use GraphQL query variables to change the value of the ID we get. So to start out, we'll add a query variable symbolized by $ID, and we'll define the type of this variable as ID type. And then in these parentheses where we specify the variable of 1, we'll change the value of that to have $ID. So whatever value we input into this query will be added here. And we'll do this whenever we're making our GraphQL requests. Now that we've changed the value of our query, we can go into our underscore slug file and add single articles query as our page query. We'll change all articles query to single articles query. And then in our Apollo section, we'll copy that name and paste that here. However, our article won't work if we don't place variables. So we go on a new line and initialize a variables function. In this function, we return an ID that is this.route.query.id. Now you must be wondering why we're using this value. If we go back to our index.view file, in our Nuxt link component, besides the path, which is our article slug, we added a query item, which is our article ID, into the URL so that when we're on that page, we're able to get the article ID and fetch the relevant data for that article. So in underscore slug, we're using the this keyword and the Nuxt route functionality to get our route ID, which we'll use as an ID to fetch the relevant data for our page. Let's change this value from articles to article because we get back a single entry. And now we can start interpolating and rendering the data in the page. Like I mentioned, the structure is pretty similar to our index.view page. The first thing we want to do is replace lyric blog with article title. And below lyric blog, we want to have a description. So we'll have a p tag and give this a class of center. And then have our article.description here. Next up, we want to actually display the body. We want the styling of this page to be centered. So we'll add a center class here and here and get rid of this div tag. So we'll use a PE tag and display our article.body in this section. Now we want to be able to navigate to our previous page. So we use the Nuxt link component again, and this time give this a value of home symbolized by the backslash and a class of back. We'll have a text value of back and then close out our Nuxt link component. In our styling section below headline, we'll paste out the CSS class back so that our back text has a color specified. We'll save our work and go back to our browser. When we click an entry, we have the title, the description, and the lyrics show up. And when we click the back button, we go back to our data. Now that we've built out our blog, we can deploy it to Netlify, which we'll do in our next mission.